glad we don't need to see Baz dabbing here.
I know, because Dab's doing it, that's why. But yeah, that was before the song Dab came out, and Baz has just, he's got this horrendous celebration there, so I don't know where that's came from, but hopefully he stops it. But I'll let him do one more if he scores at the weekend.
What a header for Gil Platner to get his back in it.
Wee Pirlo has just made it too
much. Some fight back, 10 minutes to go, we didn't think the game was done, and kept going, and it was a brilliant occasion to see the scenes there. It was good to be a part of, and to take it back to Easter Road. Never a pen.
Just assault, that was all. What a finish for Nicky Clark. It's obviously on his weaker left foot, but
it's Danny Lennon. Random.
Is it 1-0?
Yeah, 1-0. It's 2-1. Dug in for about 90 minutes. This was brilliant. I hadn't heard it up until this game, so I know it's a special song for the Hibs fans, and that night it was a sellout, so it was brilliant to hear that night.
Scottish Cup seem to bring the best out of us this year. It was the second goal, in my opinion, is probably one of the best goals of the season. Some of the playing involved in it, and we hope to score in the header. I don't know what happened there. The wee garden though managed to nod it in at the back post, yeah. But it was good to get a goal myself. I'm not too sure about celebration, I need to sort of look at them, but it's better than dabbing, isn't it?
Right.
Better than dabbing.
Well, this is probably our toughest game of the season. Not performance-wise, but mentally. It was 3 days after losing the League Cup in the last minute, so to come back and score two early goals and see the game out, what we managed to do was massive.
Inverness peg one back, 2-1.
Aye,
and then obviously
the Alamo last 10 minutes.
Oh,
here we go. I'm his roommate, and he would have told me if he was doing something like that, but I just had a feeling when he put the ball down, something different was coming. He's got that in his locker, he's that kind of player. As we'll see later on, he's got the nerve to go and hit it again. Ended up
no
going
it again, but
nah.
No,
right, he says he thought about it. And
you know, Kenny Miller's been doing that for years, and he's reacted to it very sharply, and he's got the goal. It's sort of settled the nerves and let us just do what we do. Honestly, I see Baz do that more often than not. His ability is second to none.
Barry used to do that against us when he was at Killie when he was 13 and 14. It's no surprise to me that on a big day like that he produced. Conrad was trying to put off the Dundee United players by shouting the direction we're going to go, and it seemed to work.
Simpson.
On a day, look at him. Next up's me, absolutely bricking it, but thankfully I hit the net. And
some feeling, but innit?
Aye. Relief more than it now, sure.
Aye. Just followed John Soot, watched it the day before, and I thought I'd go the same side. It was a good penalty, so I went the same way.
He was actually smiling on the way up. Yeah, there's none else for him. And I think you see the Kawashima, he thinks he's going to chip it. It's a brutal penalty, but it hits the back of the net at the end of the day, and to get back to Hampden for another national final was a day we'll never forget.
I'd rather one of your boys scored the penalty to sort of win the game, but it went on to give me the best sort of experience I've ever felt in a football park, because it's hard to explain when you're caught up in that build-up and the expectation, and you're just waiting for the game to come, and in a massive game like that to beat your rivals in a very good performance. It was just unbelievable, and I think I'll be doing well to beat many days like that in my career. It's been a very good campaign for the both of us. We've beat a lot of good teams on the way, a lot of SPL teams, and it's, you know, it should set up for a good final on Saturday.